As I told you, every week I will try to cover a few topics based on my availability. And if you want to contribute, you can contribute. Okay. And okay. Drop duplicates. This is a very, very important and very easy in Spyspark. In general, in real time, we have a different methods to drop the duplicates, and especially in Hive and SQL, we have methods. But we can in SQL, right? We have a rank, dense rank, row number, and distinct group by. So many methods are there to find out the duplicates and drop. Here also, we have a pre-built function is there. So, in one step, we can able to delete record level duplicates. Okay, I'm repeating record level duplicates. Right. Do you know what is drop duplicates function earlier? Anybody?
No.
Okay, no problem. We'll see many many pre-built functions, you know. You might heard many news right in the previous days. Whenever we attend any interviews, people definitely ask you, do you know how to prepare on UDFs? Okay, because some of the functions are not inbuilt to the particular technology, so we have to make our own UDFs, then we have to use. So that's where UDFs concept is very important. Of course, now also it is very important, but good news is many such type of functions implemented in a recent releases, especially in Spark. Okay, that is one of the method is called drop duplicates, and we'll see many other which are very useful without creating any UDFs. We will try to achieve our result set whatever we desired. So that also we'll see in coming sessions. Okay, guys, I'm again repeating what are the topics that I'm trying to tell you. Purely, you know, majority topics I will choose based on my experience and based on my real-time projects which currently I'm working on or previously I worked on. So don't get bored. If you get bored, please let me know. But still you have to learn because I'm not covering only for interview purpose. Okay, I'm covering for your real-time answer because these are the scenarios I'm just explaining only step by step. But in real time, right, to develop one job, we may use all these functions. Sometimes we may use majority functions. Okay, so when we club all these things, then yes, that time we come to know, okay, these are the functions we have already used. That is where I'm just taking individually and explaining. Okay, now, so this, you know, I have taken one more data set. I just, you know, let me show you that data set which I'm using now. This is the I just taken from the master data set. I only, you know, I can say, yeah, I just taken a 12 columns, 12 records, and then deleted the rest of the you know, records from 1000. And what I did, I intentionally created this sheet. These are the duplicates. Okay, these are the duplicates. If you observe, these five records are repeated up, repeating of this top. Okay, this five, top five and last five are same. Okay, so that is the reason I'm repeating. This is a record level duplicates. Record level, when I say record level duplicates, means exactly the same, exactly the same. Okay, and if it's not record level duplicates, sometimes what there is a scenario where we have to remove duplicates based on our primary key data. Let us say I want to delete entire record based on only three columns. Let us say invoice ID and city, and I can say date. If these are common, then please delete the rest of the data. So that type also there. Okay, but I'm not considering, I'm not explaining that you know, option in this topic, but I'm just going to explain how to remove a duplicates if we have a complete record level. Okay. So if you observe, as I told you, top five and last five are same. Okay, so now we can say total we have a 17 records. Out of 17 records, we have only 12 are unique records. Okay, Now we have to do we have to remove duplicates by using drop duplicate function in PySpark. Let me open this. Again, I'm creating this is a file name is different. Just now whatever we have seen, that is the file name. The file I already uploaded. You know how to upload and all. You can I will try to when I upload this video in YouTube, right, in the description you see I will try to give a path for this data sets also, whatever I'm using, okay, so that you can just download from there and try to practice your own. Okay, you no need to create your own data, you can just utilize and try to save your time and practice it. If you are interested, you can also get it from internet. I have no issues. Come to this topic, I'm just going to create the again a data frame by using CSV file. Let me run it. Yeah, so if you see we have 17 records only, okay, 17 records. These are the records, so these are the records, right? But as I told you, in this 17, right, we have a five duplicates are there. We have to remove the duplicates. To remove the duplicates, let us say, anyway, this invoice ID is unique, right? So I can take any column. I think the specific column like invoice ID is very unique, right? So I want to use this invoice ID. Based on this invoice ID, I want to, remove the duplicates, okay? So for that, what I'm doing, this is my data frame. I'm using this data frame and creating a new data frame. Okay, that is without duplicates. So just use this data frame dot drop duplicates. This is the function that we are discussing right now from PySpark, and give the column name. Okay, whatever the column that you want to select. So this is the syntax. You have to give like this only. You should not remove these square brackets. If you remove these square brackets, it won't work. Okay. So let me run this in front of you. Yeah. See here, we are able to see only 12 records. Okay. You don't need to do anything here, right? Simply you just using drop duplicates and removing it. See here, we are seeing only 12 records. Only 12 records. Okay. There's any, that's it about the drop duplicates, but I want to further continue and explain one more small transformations. It will be also very, very important. If you are clear till this, then I will move forward and explain the topic also. It will take hardly 5 minutes. Any questions or hope this might be, and you got this clarity on this topic? Any queries on this? Is it easy?
Harish, if you drop both the records, or it return only one record out of two?
No, it will pick only one record. See, okay. This is the first record, whatever unique, it will take only one.
Okay.
If we drop it both the records, drop. If we drop both the records, then our count should be 7 records only, right?
Yes. Yeah.
We dropped only duplicates.
So is it dropping first 5 records or last 5 records?
Okay. That you just to do some investigation.
Okay. Thank you.
Anyway, no need to worry about it, because our intention to get the only unique records. Okay. It doesn't mind which record it got dropped. And you cannot identify also, right? How can you identify when both are the same? Right? Okay.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Sure.
Hope this is clear. And you can explore, you can use multiple columns and you can select, and after dropping, you can also select specific columns, like, right, how to select specific columns. You put dot and select it. Okay, you know the syntax and all. You can do that, okay? But here what I'm doing, I'm just showing all the columns, whatever are available inside this data frame. But if you want specific columns, that also you can select. You know very well, just now we already practiced it. Okay. And now in real time, right? After removing duplicates, we cannot simply leave like this. Our intention is to, you know, this is actually table. Then, you know, not actual table. Generally, you know, in real time, right? When we first of all, we'll try to create a table by using, let us say, hive. And then we'll use some round number function or distinct or any group by. So there are a few you know inbuilt functions are there, and we have to follow some steps to remove the duplicates and load the inuit records into other table. Okay, that is the general step that we follow in legacy. But by using Spark also, right? Let us say if data is huge. When we use Hive with MapReduce, it will take a lot of time to do all this pre-processing, right? But when you use Spark, then it is very much, very much, very much faster, as you know, very much more than 100% faster than the in MapReduce. So we'll do our data cleaning in just like that if we have a memory in our cluster. So what we will do, we will try to create a data frame out of this table. You know, since we have created a data frame from the you know file, right? Now, in coming sessions, we'll try to explain how to create a table, how to create a table first, then on top of it, how to create a data frame. Okay. So in real time, let us assume the data is already present in a table. Okay. Now we have, and we know that the table contains the duplicates. Now our intention is, our aim is to remove the duplicates without taking much time. So if that is the case, then the system is already developed with this MapReduce program, but it's taking long time. So you have to remediate that code by using PySpark without changing the functionality. Then what we can do, we can just create a data frame, okay? We can create a data frame from the files which got loaded, you know, back in that particular file, particular table location, or you can create a data frame, you know, out of table also. Okay. So let us assume this is the, you know, table location where the table got created in Hive. Then we can also create, we can also follow the same manner to create a data frame by using this method. Now we have created a table, data frame. Then we have used this logic, and finally we got, got unique records. Now our intention is to reload data into that particular table. Okay, we can use either insert statement directly, or if you want to create one temporary table, that also is possible. Okay, when we integrate Hive with Spark, right? So whatever you try to save the data or save the table, you can create the table as well as save the data in particular DB. Okay, particular Hive DB also is possible when we do Hive and Spark integration. Okay, just assume up to that only, but I want to explain how to save this data in a table. Okay, and how to run our own SQL queries on top of it. That is what we are going to discuss now. Okay. Now, see, when function, we already discussed in the last class, and with column also, we have already discussed last class. Okay. If you haven't watched, please go through the previous recording sessions, you will get to know. If you want to use when function, you have to import specifically. Then I imported. Then, this is the data frame of this, right? So out of this, I want to do small transformation here. I want to create one column that is a feedback, okay? Based on this rating, the customer has given some feedback, like good, let us say good or average. This product is good or average. Let us assume if a product is greater than, a rating is greater than one, then greater than seven, then we can give the good feedback. If a product rating is less than seven, then in other case, we will give average, okay? So that I want to see in a next column, okay? Not in rating. Rating should be as it is. And I want to create one more column called feedback. In that, I want to give that rating, okay? Now for that, right, this is the syntax, okay? This is the syntax. We have to use the previous data frame. This is the data frame, okay? I used, Why I'm using this data frame? Because this is having unique records, okay? It makes sense, right? When we use the unique records of data frame, okay? Now, with column is a function to create a new column or to change the existing column name. Since this feedback is, I want to create a new column, I given the a new column name, then called feedback. And then, see, creating a column name is won't complete our work, right? We have to insert the data also in that column, right? To do so, I just written a logic, like when this rating is greater than or equal to 7, then put good. Otherwise, make it as an average. Okay, as I discussed. So if the rating is greater than 7, greater than or equal to 7, it will give good rating. In all other cases, it will give average rating. Okay. So my intention is to want to see another column, new column with that data. Okay. So let me run this. Running this. See, we got the output. Check it. See, there's one more column called feedback. In this feedback, wherever rating is more than 7, we are seeing good. Wherever we are seeing rating is less than 7, we are seeing average. See here. Okay. So in real time, we will do this type of things many places. As it is, we can use the syntax, we can use as it is, but the logic will be changed based on the business requirement. Okay. But this is the method or way to create a new column and assign some values to it. Okay. So is it clear, guys? Is it clear?
Yes, Naresh, can I use one more logic greater than equal to 7? And if it is greater than between 5 and 7, I can use average. Less than 4, it's bad. Logics,
you can explore it. Okay, you can explore it.
Okay,
and just try. Okay, there's no big deal in it, because my intention is to get a syntax, right? Get a logic. When we have some logic, then we can play around it. Okay.
Yes.
So now this is only one transformation. But now I want to save this data in a table and run our own SQL. Okay. So how we can do that? We can do it. There is a, there are two methods. If you want to create for temporary, specific to this session and for this cluster, then we can use, create or replace temp view. It will create a temporary table, okay, in default database. And we can use as a use it like a SQL, okay, SQL table. So but if you want to create this permanently, then save as a table. There is a save as a table command. You can explore it, or if not possible, then I will try to explain in the next topics. You don't need to worry, but as of now, you just remember this one. Okay, create or replace temp view. Okay, this is the data frame, right? Whatever we are discussing now, this is the rating data frame. So rating data frame dot create or replace. This is the table name, whatever the name that you can give. Okay, I just given one table. Okay, one table name as per my wish. So you can give any table name, no worry, and just run it. Okay, just run it. Now it got ran. Okay, now this data is stored in a SQL table. So you no need to write this specific syntaxes to get the select and all, or columns or indexes, because now this is a table. We'll write a simple SQL query and pull the records. The similar way, we can use this table. Let us say, percentage SQL. When you use percentage SQL, right, we can run all SQL related. Okay. If you want to, we have a different. Like you can say languages we can use here, Python, SQL, or Scala. Okay, as of now, these four or five languages will be supported by this Databricks. So by default, it will give a Python shell only. If you want to run a different language, then you have to explicitly mention percentage SQL. Okay, So now this is a table name, right? This is a table name which I which we got created. So simply you can write your SQL query. You can run SQL query, you'll get it. Okay. So if you can also count, you can also do the count. You can write all the SQL queries. Okay, this in real time we generally we follow, but we won't do temporary. We will try to save that table, and from that we will use the unique records. So actually, you know, this step will happen before it reaching to main table in real time. Okay, main table. Okay. Before that, we have a temporary table. And temporary table, let us say we have 17 records with 5 records got a duplicate. Now we will use temporary table of 17 records. Then we'll process it, or we will remove the duplicates of 5 records and load this remaining 12 unique records into our main table. Okay, that is the flow in a real time. Okay, guys, is it clear? Any questions?
Nothing. Can we use both domain-specific languages along with SQL in real time, or we have to follow either one of it, or do we have any performance issues in case of using both?
No, as of now, I mean, as per my knowledge, no performance issues. Okay, that is clear. Both are almost same. Okay, performance-wise, you won't see any differences. And in real time, you can use whatever you wish. But people recommend you to use DSL. Okay. But see.
This data community.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I was about to ask you, like, don't we need to create the Spark session object every time in this Databricks community?
No, not required. In Databricks community, it's not required. It's already pre-built. But you know, right, how to create. Okay. You know how to create, right? Spark session, you can create it, but it's in real time we have to create. Okay guys, so yeah, these three topics that I planned for this week, and through the session I also want to explain, want to give you one general information. I have a free as well as premium just folders, almost 90 GB of data is already present in this folder. This is not shared with many people, just sharing with very limited people. Here, what I'm doing, I'm just trying to collect the material from the different tutorials and placing all this into this folder. Okay, as of now, I gather 90 GB of data. I placed in a single place where you can explore it.
Hello?
Yes?
Sanjeev this side. I have a doubt. I have just started my big data career. Like, I was working in a ETL project.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, I have given interview. I have studied big data tech stack on my own, and I have given interview. So I'm selected in Cognizant and Genpact as a consultant, and one with a Bangalore startup. It's an AI startup. So there I've been selected on my PySpark skills and Hive SQL skills. So I have seen the market the salary range they are giving for cloud-based data engineers, the salary they are giving is very competitive than a data engineer. So I want to start learning cloud. So I need a suggestion, which one should I choose, AWS or Azure? What are the leaders in the market in data engineering?
Just give me 2-3 minutes. I will definitely come to that topic. Okay. So guys, I've been telling you, right? This is a folder where I am trying to collect all the information or other data. Anyway, I will continue the sessions, my sessions. And in addition to that, I also, gathering the information and placing it here. Okay. These are one source, completely premium. You can see here all AWS or Tableau, other materials, many materials I covered because it is already 90 GB here. And why I'm telling you all these things, and I will share the this link only for the members, okay, whoever is joining in Clever Studies. For them, I want to give a special privileges for them. So in of course these classes and all, anyway it is free. I'm not charging anything because I want to give you some, you know, input to you all. But coming to this material, if this is completely optional, it's not a mandatory. If you feel you want to utilize this, all this material as well as this material, and your special, any special guidance and a resume preparation or mock interview, all will be, I will try to extend my support for the persons who has subscribed and who has joined as a member. Okay, this is a small announcement, and this is completely optional. Okay, it's up to you. But whoever joined, please try to ping me in a group chat or send a mail that I joined. Please give me link access. So for them, I will explicitly give the access for this link so that you can explore all this topic. Okay, so this is only small announcement. Anything else on this? In coming sessions, right, if I get time, also I will try to start Snowflake. I've been telling you people, Snowflake is a very, very important tool. 70% of data engineer projects are going to migrate to Snowflake. So it is good to know or good to learn and get an excellent certification within this year, if not possible, at least in the next 6 months or at least in a year. So along the Spark, Snowflake is a very, very important tool that we have to learn, okay? So in upcoming sessions after Spark, or if I get extra time, definitely I will try to take a session, other extra session also. I'm still learning Snowflake. Whatever I learn, I will try to share that knowledge to you. Get a clarity on the topics and try to understand. And in a week, right, whenever you get a time, please practice it. So in coming few months, definitely you will get a good knowledge, as well as you will be in good stage to work on real time. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So somebody's asking, right? So coming to cloud, yeah, definitely most of the projects are migrating to cloud. As I told you, Snowflake is using cloud only backend. Okay, to store the data, Snowflake is using anyone from the three cloud technologies like Azure, GCP, and Amazon AWS. So you can, but to learn Snowflake, you no need to have a very strong knowledge in cloud. But if you have a cloud knowledge also, it is an added advantage. Okay.
Yeah, like I am confused. Like I have not started learning any cloud technology. So like I want to start. So like I'm confused, like which one to choose. Like there are openings regarding AWS also, there are openings regarding Azure also. So
see, like which one? Let me tell you, AWS are already proven. Okay. Many, almost 70% it occupied in a market, I can say. And many people already have very good knowledge in AWS, right? So AWS is always good to go, but Azure is also Azure and GCP is also people are learning. Okay, so I can say Azure also started working, and many people are already started using Azure with Spark. And if you learn Azure, then maybe it will be useful for both the Spark as well as the Snowflake. Okay. And AWS, you know, when you go for any interview, right, you may face very tricky questions, or because the experts are already in the panel. But Azure, I don't think those many people are already present in the market, or GCP also. So I can say, if you're not passionate about AWS, you can go for Azure. If you don't want to go with you don't want to take any risk, or I am ready to go with any technologies, then you go for AWS.
Okay. Because when I was interviewed with Genpact, So like they asked me whether you have any cloud knowledge. So I told that I'm not working on any cloud technology, but I have knowledge about like Azure. So they asked me basic questions about Azure, like what is ADF and what is Synapse, for what type of data Synapse stores, and what is ADLS.
So, okay, understood. You can go ahead. You can go ahead, Azar. No problem. And guys, we have only less than 1 minute. I'm not going to extend the session because it automatically closed. Any other questions within 40 seconds?
That's it for today. Do you have any more sessions, Naresh?
We don't have any sessions as of now. But I will come up with a next topic in next session. Recordings also will be uploaded in a very, very, very soon in a YouTube channel. And please try to tell to your friends and colleagues if they want to learn or get some knowledge, ask them to join because it is free. Okay, I request you to join in my as a member and get an extra benefit. Okay, guys, thanks for the time.